What's up, Wichita? Thanks for tuning in to Live Local. I'm here with Jeff of Village Travel. Go. We're here in the shop and he's going to tell us a little bit about what they do here. So Jeff?
Village Travel, we've been here in the Wichita market since 1980. So we're celebrating 40 years next year. And the company started out doing ski trips from Wichita to the mountains and actually did not start as a bus company. It was actually flying people, using commercial airlines, flying out to Colorado. The problem was when they'd get people out to Colorado to the mountains, they were having a hard time getting good buses to take care of the skiers. So business was good, but they were having problems on that end. So the founders of Village bought a bus and they sent it straight out there to do shuttles to the mountains.
Okay.
And so after ski season was over, bus came back to Wichita and started doing Kansas City Royals trips and other charters. And then the business just started evolving, and pretty soon the charter part of the business got to be a big part of the business. And then the ski tour started evolving into a lot more than just ski tours. You know, going to the East Coast and West Coast, Fall Foliage, Brants, and all sorts of stuff. And so basically, what started out as a ski tour company has now evolved into a company that we do charters, we still do the tours. We have a scheduled line service, much like Greyhound. Mm-hmm. We have a full service travel agency, and we also have an entertainer coach division. So we encompass a lot of things related to motor coaches and travel, and we've expanded out of Wichita now into 6 other markets. So Wichita's headquarters, but we're running 139 coaches, and we have almost 400 employees. So it's become a very big business, but we're still based right here in Wichita.
So I live very close to this area, and I watched this facility be built pretty much from the ground up, just uh-huh. coming to and from work every day. It's a beautiful facility.
Thanks.
And it's brand new right here, Northwest Wichita.
For those of you that have been around Wichita a long time, Village started at 21st and Tyler. And at the time that building was built, it was wheat fields everywhere, as far as you can see. And it got to the point where we outgrew the building, but also that traffic outgrew us. It was getting to be very difficult for the buses getting out of 21st Street. So we started exploring options on building a new building, and I really had my eye on this intersection at K96 and Ridge, and we're the first business to go north of K96 on Ridge Road, and we had to elevate that land 6 feet because it was in the floodplain. So
wow.
There's a lot of dirt moving, and we're excited to be here, and we feel like this building is going to last us for another 40 years. So we built it for the long haul, and it's been really fun.
So we're here in the shop, and here, so y'all do all your own local maintenance and everything on all the charter buses and everything that you have?
Yeah, charter buses require quite a bit of maintenance, and so we have to have a really good staff of folks that know what they're doing. And these buses are brought in on a regular basis based on the miles that they travel, and so they're brought in for routine inspections and services. But then there's also the unscheduled events that happen if, you know, a windshield gets cracked or something isn't quite working right. The buses are brought in and worked on. So it's a pretty big undertaking, but we have a very well maintained fleet, some of the best in the country.
So who are some of the people that charter buses from you? Is it, you know, NFL teams? Is it local civilians? Like, who is your main client?
You know, it's all the above, everything that you've mentioned. But some of the big clients on the charter side of our business, the Army,
okay.
The Army up in Junction City, they charter a lot. Oklahoma State University, major Division I colleges that come in and play at Oklahoma State and OU and in Manhattan and in Lawrence. Also smaller colleges, a lot of churches. There's also corporate business. There's middle school kids going to Worlds of Fun. There's political charters. There's you'd be amazed how many people need buses.
Right.
It's really interesting. And that's on the charter side. On the entertainer coach side, those are like band and crew buses. So we're going out doing shows. So this last year, we had we were on the Hugh Jackman tour. He did a Greatest Showman tour. And so we had 7 coaches out there with that, hauling the crew that sets up the stage, tears down the stage. We have artists like Jamie Johnson out of Nashville that travel with us. A lot of rock bands like Incubus, Social Distortion. So we have comedians. I mean, there's a lot of folks that are rolling around and our coaches in the middle of the night going from venue to venue all over the country. Yeah. So that keeps us on our toes, and it also keeps it pretty exciting.
And so your drivers go through an extensive training before they're hired on?
So we have a couple of classifications of drivers. We have our full-time drivers, which this is their career. They don't just start out as full-time drivers. They've gotten experience driving trucks, school buses, or driving for us part-time, and then working their way up to it. And so we just have to spend a lot of time with them, getting them acclimated to what it's like driving a charter bus, and then just kind of ease them into it. So, but over time, they get more confident, and we get more confident. And then there's annual retraining, and there's a lot of required meetings and studying that they're required to do every year.
Well, Jeff, thanks for having me out to Village Travel today. It's quite the establishment, and right here in Wichita, Kansas. Thanks for being local.
You bet. It's great.
As always, I'm Troy.
I'm Jeff.
And we're reminding you to live local.